Okay, I'm on my Project 640, and I've had a little bit of play in the clutch lever. When I throttle up, the pressure point of the clutch lever would change. So I'm taking the clutch and I'm inspecting it. All the plates and discs look good. The O-ring's on the outside where it's supposed to be in the first disc. And that part of it looks good. I'll measure them after. And then the inner drum has a little bit of play, which is probably okay. But the outer drum seems to have a little more movement. I don't like that amount of movement. Maybe that's part of the problem. Anyways, I'm gonna pop it apart and see. And my big cheater bar, there, she come loose. It wasn't too bad. So we're gonna take her off and see what the bearing looks like. Maybe the bearing's just worn in her hub out. Have a look. Okay, the spacer is okay. Looks all right. Okay, now we'll pull the hub out. It's nice and smooth. Here's the spacer. Bearing looks good. Now that's all right. Now what I'm worried about is the bearing may have moved out. Distinct possibility, so we'll check that next. To do that, we're gonna have to pull the gear off the oil pump. Make sure we don't lose the key. And the washer. Snap ring and washer. Set back over there. Okay, pull the oil pump gear off. A little bit stubborn, and we better take the pin out. The gear looks good, still in good shape. Okay, here's the retaining bracket, and it does feel like the bearing is past flush. The shaft does have quite a bit of play, which is more than it should. You can see that. So that, I think, is where the problem lies. I'm going to have to drive that bearing back in and put another plate on here. That is way too much play in that shaft. This is Loctited in place, so and the screws aren't even tight. I have a feeling this whole plate has worn and allowed the bearing to slip out. This is what I suspected when I took it apart at the beginning. It's happened to other people. And there it is. The bearing has moved. So the solution, I guess, is to drive the bearing back in flush and install another plate on there. And that should fix it up. So that's the problem, and I'm sure other people, if you feel your clutch moving, especially under power, then it's to check that this bearing, the whole bearing hasn't pushed out. And there was a bulletin from KTM a while back that talked about this, and they did have a special retainer plate that actually held the bearing in past flush, and they had a recall on certain models. So this plate I'll be replacing. I went through my spare parts and I dug out another bearing retainer. Here's the one that came out of the bike with the wear, and this is one out of my spare parts I took out of another engine, and it's got very little, just a little bit of wear showing down here. So this one, what I'll do is I'll drive the bearing back in and put this retainer in there, and hopefully that'll be the end of the problems. Now what could happen is the bearing could shift out again, and if I feel that clutch point moving, I'm gonna pull the entire bearing out and then I'll put it back in with retaining compound, something like Loctite 648, which should bond the bearing in. But for right now, I'm gonna just take and warm the case around the bearing, and then I'm going to take a piece of black ABS pipe, and this is 1¾ inch inside diameter, and that slips, and that'll be my driver to drive the bearing back in. And so I'm going to use the heat gun here to warm the case, and what I'm going to do to try to get the maximum differential between the case and the bearing is I'm going to just put a shield so I can stop heating the bearing and only the case, to keep the heat off the bearing to get that differential. So that's what I'm going to do right now, is get the heat gun going on it. So I just got a piece of bathroom tub faucet hollowed out, and this is going to be my shield, and I can just hold it off the bearing and it'll stop the heat from going in. And my well-built Chinese heat gun, which has been working pretty good. That should be enough. I know it's hot because I can't hold that pipe anymore. So I'll get my driver on there. Wow, that went in awful easy. So the bearing went in pretty easy, and it actually drove in a little bit too far. So what I did is I just took my slam puller, I put the clutch nut on, and then I hooked it on the edge of that nut, and then I just slammed it back, and it just gave enough slack to free the shaft. Now it turns thin and there's minimum amount of play, but I'm a little worried that bearing's gonna slop back and forth again. But there's not much I can do, and if it does it again, I'm just gonna pull the bearing out and then put some retaining compound in. There's not much else I can do with it. But it's a lot better than it was. I'm gonna start putting it back together again. You got to remember when you put the new screws in, is to apply Loctite. So I'm going to clean these out, squirt some Loctite in, and then put the plate back in there, and hopefully that'll keep that bearing from shifting. Obviously, it has had a history of having problems when KTM puts this retaining plate on. I kind of wish they would have put a retaining plate right around on the top and the bottom of the bearing. That would have ended all the troubles, but we'll have to go with it how it is.
Weight's going back in.
There's 10 newton meters on the torque. Okay, once again, make sure the pump shaft is horizontal. If you have it up and down, the drive pin might drop right out into the sump, and then you gotta fish it out with a magnet. So once again, horizontal. Slide the second gear in place. Put a little slot and pry the pump shaft out. That should do it. Okay, then goes the washer. The C clip. And once again, needle nose pliers. Boy, this one is a lot more stubborn than the first pump. There it goes. That's the starter freewheel gear. Turns nice and smooth. And you want to squirt some oil into the main shaft bearings. Just to make sure that it's got a good startup. And give it a little bit of a spin. Distribute the oil. Bearing on this is in very good shape. It turns smooth, so what I usually do is I'll load the bearing up again with oil. Just to make sure there's lots of oil in there. Put the bearing freewheel washer back in. And slide it on the shaft. Okay, there was the kickstart gear. Freewheel gear, you gotta engage that. And then the oil pump gears, you gotta line the teeth up on those. There, now it slides in place. Clutch hub is in place. And there you go. So next you have your retainer, clutch retainer, and I would dry the threads off for when you torque it. It should have dry threads whenever you torque something like this. There's 75. Shape drift. Take the drift and send the tab washer over. Okay, basket's in place. First thing you want to do is get the O-ring in first. Push that all the way to the back. That's kind of like a damper. It stops the first plate from sticking. And whenever I put the clutch together, I'll either soak the plates in oil, or in this case, they're still damp from just taking it apart, so I just give a little treatment of oil to both sides of the plate. And this will stop them from sticking when you first start up. Okay, there we go. Okay, remember what I mentioned earlier about lining up the hole in here with the index mark on the clutch pack. And it is right down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop a bunch of lube in the shaft throw-out bearing. So that shaft is pointed almost straight down to here. So then I turn the mark to correspond, and voila, there it is, lines up. And next goes the springs, go back in. And you noticed I was really careful, and I managed to save the gasket. The gasket is reusable a couple times. You can get away with it as long as you're careful removing it. Okay, so now that's in place, take my ratchet screwdriver, set it to a really low torque. There's 88 inch pounds. I did a diagram kind of the housing and picture of how the screws go. Get my clutch. I look at the seal here. Sometimes I usually replace it, but this time I won't. It looks pretty good still. So I load up that seal with oil. And another thing that's important is to load up the crankshaft with oil. It'll start to back out of there. So. And there's the cover back in. So I always put the two with the, we got the copper washers, the sealing washers. Those ones go into the, they go into the ones with the dowels on them. Here's the other one. And that's about it. The rest is just put the last oil line on and the gear shift and whatnot. Kickstart and the kickstart first, then the gear shift, and then the foot peg. So that's it. Job done. Hopefully it'll last and that bearing won't shift again, but we'll see.